So I'm Edwige Moyroud. I'm a plant biologist, and at the moment I'm based in the Sainsbury Laboratory in Cambridge. Well, that would be difficult to choose what the most exciting thing in the field of plant science at the moment. I really like to understand how things are made. So my natural instinct is toward development, and I really like to look at things from how things were made the way they were made. So I like the evolutionary insight. But I think the thing that excites me the most at the moment is the fact that we can now ask the most relevant question in the most relevant species. So 15 years ago, it was really difficult to do anything in a species that wasn't deemed a model species. And suddenly now, with next generation sequencing and all sorts of very exciting technology, we can start working on this exciting species, answering brand new questions. Okay, so thinking about advice for early career researchers, I always have an ambivalent view about advice. I always ask lots of advice, and I can say I follow half of them and completely ignore the other half. So my first advice is, an advice is just an advice. But I think some of the best advice I think that my PhD supervisor used to tell me, and one kind of mantra I kept with me is always think about the question, and then the technology come next. So if you stick about the question and then think about what excites you about it and then how you can answer it. And if you know what to do, great, do it. If you don't know, look at, can I learn this technique? Can I learn this new method? Or if not, can I collaborate with people that will help me? And I think no matter what you work on, if you follow the question, then you'll end up in a great place. So this next generation scientist meeting organized by New Phytologist and similar meeting that are sometimes organized, I think I find them really appealing because I'm easily overwhelmed by large meeting, and especially as a young starting PhD student, I remember not knowing where to go and what to follow. So this meeting with just one session are much easier to engage with. I also like the fact that it's a selection of PhD student, master student, postdoc from very, very different background. And because it works on people being selected, it means you don't come with a big group. So this means that you are forced to network. And at the same time, it's less overwhelming because you feel you're surrounded by your peer. The thing I really like about being a scientist is the creativity, the feel like you can take a really simple question, like, I mean, in our case, we're trying to understand how flowers are patterned. And flowers have been patterned for millions of years, but nobody had figured out how it works. And the idea that suddenly we can start getting little insight about this little movie that happened all the time, but nobody know how it works, I think for me is the most exciting thing. And the fact that you can take wherever your imagination is taking you. And most of the time it will fail, but at least you feel like you're trying to answer a really general question about how life works. And there's probably not many more things I can think of that would be as exciting as doing that. There are people that are very good at compartmentalizing their life and having the professional life and the work life. And I think as scientists, everybody need a work-life balance, but I feel the same whether I'm at home or at work. So sometimes I feel I can really relax at home watching, box sets and eating ice cream. But sometimes I come to home and I have to do tidying up and cleaning. And actually I'm quite happy to go back to the lab to relax by doing an experiment I really wanted to do. So it's, relaxing, it doesn't always happen outside the lab. I really enjoy what I'm doing. But I like listening to all sorts of podcasts and radio and doing lots of non-scientific reading, mostly novels.